Hello. In this class, we will learn types and characteristics of medium and trace elements. It can be divided into two parts. First of all, we will learn the type and characteristics of medium element, and next we will learn the type and characteristics of trace element. The first one, medium element. As to the kind and features of medium element, there are three kinds: calcium, magnesium, sulfur. A. The nutritional requirements of plants for calcium, magnesium, and sulfur. Calcium. Form and distribution of calcium in plants. Generally, there is a 0.2% to 1.0% calcium in plants. It is mainly distributed in stems and leaves. Older leaves are higher than young ones. There are few roots, seeds, and fruits. Physiological role of calcium. Calcium is a component of calcium pectin in the intercellular layer of the cell wall. It is associated with cell division. It stabilizes biofilms. It can combine with organic acids to insoluble calcium salts so as to release the harm to the plant when the organic acid accumulates too much. Activator of a few enzymes, cannot move in the plant, and cannot be reused. Second, magnesium. Form and distribution of magnesium in plants. Generally, the content of magnesium in plants is 0.1% to 0.6%. It is highest in the seeds. Stems and leaves are the next highest, and least in roots. Physiological role of magnesium. It is an important component of chlorophyll. It is an activator of many enzymes, and it plays an important role in photosynthesis. Third, sulfur. Form and distribution of sulfur in plants. Generally, the content of sulfur is 0.1% to 0.5% in plants. It is mainly distributed in the stems and leaves. It is low in the seeds and roots. Physiological role of sulfur. It is an indispensable component of proteins and many enzymes. 2. Types and characteristics of calcium, magnesium, and sulfur fertilizers. First, calcium fertilizer. Common calcium fertilizers are shown in the table. Calcium quicklime. Its main component is calcium oxide. Its active ingredient content is 60.3%. It appears as white powder or lump. It is strongly alkaline and water absorbent. It reacts with water to produce high heat, thus converting it into slaked lime. It can well neutralize acids. Slaked lime. The main component is calcium hydroxide. Its active ingredient content is 46.1%. It appears as a white powder. It has strong alkalinity. It can well neutralize acids. It does not generate high heat when being used. It is commonly used as a lime fertilizer. Second, magnesium fertilizer. Common magnesium fertilizer as shown in the table. Magnesium sulfate. The main component is magnesium sulfate. The active ingredient content is 20%. It has high solubility. It appears as white, fine, oblique, or oblique columnar crystals. Magnesium chloride. The main component is magnesium chloride. The active ingredient content, 25.6%. It is easy to deliquesce. It is easily soluble in water. Third, sulfur fertilizer. Common sulfur fertilizers are shown in the table. Raw gypsum. The main components are dihydrate and calcium sulfate. The active ingredient content is 18.6%. It appears as a powder and is slightly soluble in water. Heated, it will dehydrate to cooked gypsum. Cooked gypsum. The main components are half water and calcium sulfate. The active ingredient content is 20.7%. It appears as white powder. It is with high hygroscopicity. Phosphogypsum. The main components are dihydrate and calcium sulfate. The active ingredient content, 11.9%. It is acidic and easy to absorb moisture. Part 2. The types and characteristics of micronutrient fertilizers. Trace element fertilizers mainly contain boron, zinc, molybdenum, manganese, iron, copper, etc., and inorganic salts and oxides of nutrients. 1. The pattern of plant nutrient requirements for trace elements. Boron. Dicotyledonous plants contain more boron than monocotyledonous plants. The content in reproductive organs are higher than that of nutritional ones. The content in leaf blades are higher than that of branches. The content in branches are higher than that of roots. Physiological role of boron. Boron affects the development of reproductive organs. It affects cell elongation and division in crops. It plays an important role in flowering and fruit set. Zinc. It is mainly concentrated in roots and apical growing points and young leaves. The content of it is low in leaves. Physiological role of zinc. It is a component and activator of many enzymes. More than 80 zinc-containing enzymes have been identified. It is involved in the synthesis of growth hormone. Molybdenum. The content of it is higher in roots than in stems and leaves. The content of it is higher in roots than in leaves. Molybdenum is rich in reproductive organs. Physiological role of molybdenum. It is the least required essential element. It is a component of some enzymes. Molybdenum is particularly needed for nitrogen fixation by legume rhizobia. Nitrogen-fixing enzymes are composed of ferritin and ferromolybdenum. 2. Types and characteristics of common trace elements. 1. Types of micronutrient fertilizers. Boron fertilizers are borax, boric acid, boron magnesium fertilizer, and boron slurry, etc. Zinc fertilizers are zinc sulfate, zinc oxide, zinc chloride, zinc carbonate, etc. Molybdenum fertilizers are ammonium molybdate, sodium molybdate, molybdenum oxide, and molybdenum slag, etc. Manganese fertilizers are manganese sulfate, manganese chloride, manganese oxide, and manganese carbonate, etc. 2. The characteristics of each micronutrient fertilizer are shown in the table. That's all.